Namaste, Frankie. You know,
Namaste.
David says 2 o'clock. It's 2 o'clock.
I just have to say hello to Melanie and to Girma. You know, it's always so beautiful to see you guys, and you're always one of the first.
This is another Osho song for you. This is no ordinary love affair. I love somebody and there's no one there. No, just a white cloud and an empty chair. It always was, yes, and it always will. White swan and a white light from beyond the beyond. White cloud, white swan and a white light from beyond the beyond. Oh.
No, we already said namaste, didn't we? But did you see the story on stories today? I posted pictures of the three birds. You can really see them now, and we're kind of wondering when they're gonna spread their wings and fly. I don't think it's that much longer. You can hear them.
Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds outside my doorstep, yeah, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Singing, don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing it's gonna be all right. Singing, don't worry do, 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 about a thing. Do, 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 do. 'Cause every little thing is already all right. Yeah, anyway. Thank you, Bob. So we have three little birds on our doorstep. Before we just clicked to go online today, we really didn't know what we were going to play for you guys, and really we didn't. We went through one or two things, and so we just had to. David said, "Shall we just go online and see what happens?" And that's what happened. That's what happened. Yes, yes. You know, we're thinking to keep this going forever. So.
You said that same thing yesterday.
No, I didn't. I didn't say forever.
No, today, but don't say forever.
Today is forever.
No, please.
Anyway. We hope you're doing good. And we hope this brings a smile to your life and some sunshine from this jungle. And for sure, I can tell you that you are bringing a smile to our lives and some sunshine, even if it's raining. I just spoke to Rishi today in Copenhagen, Denmark. He said, oh, it's cold and raining again, you know, so we hope that even...
But I think Germany wants some rain. I think you guys need some rain.
In Germany, yeah, it's a pretty crazy world right now, isn't it? Pretty crazy. So let's meditate. And let's not waste these moments together. Let's not waste the crisis.
I mean, that's really always what meditation is about, that we find that place inside that's always untouched and unmoved of all this whirlwind that's going on. And maybe now that with this chaos that's happening in the world, it's even more easy to feel the difference between that silent center and the outside. I don't know, either it's harder to find or it's easier to feel. And it's just making that journey back and forth as often as we can from the inside, from the outside to the inside, so we are very familiar with that pathway and we can access it easily, more and more quickly.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
For us, obviously, the mantras are they make that pathway for us, you know. That's why we're here together, because we've realized how they open that doorway for us.
And you know, it's always available. I like that Osho used to say, you know, anyone can meditate in a cave in the Himalayas, but can you meditate in the marketplace when it's noisy and you're distracted? That's when you'll know how deep your meditation is. And it's like that for us now, you know, like it's not about spending these moments with us and then forgetting. I know many of you are tuned in, but I'm just saying it because it's not something that has to stop when our connection here stops. We keep it through the day, through the evening, through the morning. Keep it with you. Keep your meditation with you. Keep your awareness of your breath and that connection to your inner smile. We which we all possess as humans, as living creatures. We all possess this sense of gratitude. It's just inbuilt. It's just that we forget where it is. And we think it has to do with where we are and what we're doing and who we're with. It doesn't. So it's all about connecting with our inner sanctuary and coming home, coming home. Okay, so shall we begin?
Shall we continue?
Shall we continue, yeah. So if I know you guys, some new people are joining us all the time, so I just want to run again over our ritual so that we are in tune with each other. If you have a candle or a plant of some kind, something to bring nature into your room, this is the time now to be aware and to connect with nature in your own home space. So if you have your candle ready, you can light the candle now. If you have some incense, it's the time to move into our meditation space together, to enrich it. And be aware as we sit together that we are linking arms and hands with our brothers and sisters across the world. Mm. We are all together here, and the meditation that we share enriches every one of us. It's a gift that we give. It's not just a gift that we receive. It's a gift that we give with our intention and with our authenticity.
Yeah, and we're all really like broadcasters of energy. And
yeah.
And so, you know, that's even measurable, you know, like how many feet from the diameter around you is many feet where your energy can be felt and even measured. So as we do this, we are benefiting those around us as well, and those who live upstairs, who live downstairs, those we think about, you know. So just again, that we don't do this, we are not doing this just for ourselves. This is really this is our activism, and this is our seva as well. As pleasurable it is still seva and activism. It's still a contribution to the human field. It doesn't have to be always something that's, you know, I know in my mind often something that is a seva is uncomfortable or something that's, but this is, you know, it's beautiful on all levels. So as we close our eyes, I thought to just remind us again of lifting our eyes up to the third eye center. Maybe you still remember, because this is something that's makes such a difference within. When we lift up our gaze, even with our eyes closed, to our third eye center. And it's a conscious turning towards the light and not being entangled in the worldly matters and concerns, but we lift ourselves consciously up, our focus up to the light.
With a straight spine. Feeling comfortable, relaxing our shoulders. And staying conscious of our gaze towards the third eye. We begin with our mantra Om together with David.
Take a deep breath. And we breathe out, yes, and a deep breath. Om. Close your eyes and relax. Relax your shoulders. Relax your jaw. Relax your belly.
And straighten your spine. Bring your gaze back up to your third eye. See the light that has become very obvious since we chant the Gayatri. The night is falling, a silent voice is calling over the world, casting a shadow of light, and in this timeless time, our golden age over the world, we're casting a shadow of light, shadow of light, shadow. Shadow of light. shadow of light. See, the night is falling. A silent voice is calling over the world. It's casting a shadow of light. And in this timeless time, our golden age over the world, we're casting a shadow of light, shadow of light, shadow. Shadow of light.
somebody said, would we do Shamnamitra again?
And
then
we
go in Loka.
Okay.
Yeah. Yesterday we forgot Loka again, but not today.
Shamnu Mitra, Shamnarana, Shamnu Bhavidvaryamam, Shamnu Indru Brahaspati, Shamnu Vishnu Rukrama, Namo Brahmani, Namaste Vayu, Twamiva Pratyaksham Brahmasi, Twamiva Pratyaksham Brahma Varisyami, Ritam Varisyami, Satyam Varisyami, Tamam avatu, tatvaktaram avatu, avatu mam, avatu vaktaram. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. Sukino Balantu Loka Samasta Sukino Balantu Loka Samasta
Namaste.
Have a beautiful evening, beautiful morning, a beautiful day, beautiful life, beloveds.